Namaskara, I am Dr. Harihara Murthy. I am an ENT specialist practicing in Bangalore for more than 3 decades now. Tinnitus is a term that is used for a ringing sound in the ear. It can be pulsatile, it can be continuous, it can be intermittent, it can be persistent. Some people have tinnitus only in the nights when things are quiet. Some people have it right through the day, whether it's day or night, it doesn't make any difference. So, what are all the causes for tinnitus? There are multiple causes for tinnitus. 40 years ago, when I started training, tinnitus was a rarity and we hardly saw a few patients in a year. Now we see patients every single week. So, why is it more now than ever before? The hyperstimulation of the nerves, which is what we are seeing today as a routine, is perhaps one of the causes. Why do I say perhaps? Because the exact cause for it has not yet been identified. But having said that, many people who have tinnitus also have associated hearing loss. The hearing mechanism is such that it works like piano keys. There are different parts of the cochlear mechanism in the inner ear which are stimulated by different frequencies of sounds. So if one is exposed to high intensity or a persistent sound for a long period of time of a particular frequency, possibility of them having a loss or fatigue or weakness of the hair cells, which is the dynamo which converts sound into electrical energy. If that were to happen, then one person can perceive it as a loss of hearing and or tinnitus. So tinnitus is a very complex issue. We have seen that people who are high strung also have tinnitus. There is nothing to do with the hearing loss here. People who are high strung are high stimulated and they perceive sounds more than normal people would. Now, there's nothing else wrong with them, say that they are abnormal, but the way they perceive sounds is very high, as a result of which they are able to perceive sounds which normally are not available for you, and that can also be a cause for the tinnitus. So why do they hear it more? Imagine you are in your city and you're exposed to a lot of sounds. Chances are you don't even know those sounds or perceive those sounds, because they are commonplace. But if you were to go to some new city, maybe in the middle of Central Europe, where there's hardly anybody, and you're walking in the middle of the night on the road, and you hear some rustle of leaves, you will be able to perceive that sound, though the same thing, if it happens in your city, you won't even know it happened. Why? Because you are in a heightened state of alertness and awareness. You're able to perceive that minimal sound of a rustling leaf, unlike when you are in your own home. Likewise, these people who are in a heightened state of awareness are highly stimulated to keep awareness intact for them. They are able to perceive the sounds more than others. Completely different from a problem of loss of the hair cells. They'll have normal hearing apparatus, but they'll perceive sounds more. So these things are different. So we have to identify the causes for tinnitus first and then start treating them. There is no single method of treating tinnitus. There are multiple ways of managing it depending on the causes for the tinnitus. It is never is a one size fits all for tinnitus. Having said that, if a person is not getting relieved with any of the medication that may be offered to the person, then we give tinnitus maskers. These are machines like hearing aids which you have to wear, and that when you wear, will constantly give you a certain type of sound which masks the tinnitus. These are the only ways that we can handle tinnitus. At this point in time, medication and meditation plus tinnitus maskers may be able to help the person with tinnitus.